High Flyer Sports Academy is all set to encourage their children in skating, a sport which the government also does not support, to represent an international competition, as they were motivated by their children winning laurels in the international level. Skating is a sport a few are well versed in. Even in India or in Karnataka, there is no much of an encouragement by the government, schools or parents towards this sport, and also a very few number of children are interested in it. But in Dakshina Kannada district, Mangalore is an exception. Many have also participated at the international level and have won laurels and brought name and fame to India and Mangalore city. There is no proper rink in Mangalore except for a small one at Kadri Nantho. But the parents of these children have joined together and have formed High Flyer Sports Academy, where as they pulled in money and renovated a bit of the rink. It is very surprising that without proper speed infrastructure for the rink, these children have defeated the children of vastly advanced countries who have highly sophisticated infrastructure training and rink and have won international laurels. Let's see what Cecilia Smith has to say, who won an international medal.
I started liking skating since beginning, from childhood only, so I was very interested in all skating and all. So once after I started roller skating, I started even ice skating. So I got a chance to go once, and after going once international, it felt very nice. So I wanted to go many more times, so practice hard. And,
Who are your inspirations?
Mostly I joined skating as just a time pass thing. Then later my dad encouraged, mom encouraged all, and then after I started taking up skis.
Cricket has been recognized all over, and roller skating has not been recognized yet in Mangalore as well, and especially don't have an infrastructure here, especially for the roller skating also. You have bagged international place in ice skating also. How could you do that? Because you know Korea and other Canada, Australia and all those are very much forward. We have got infrastructure. They're from the small little age they start skating, and you don't have an ice rink here as well. How did you manage to bag a place?
Every year since 4 years we've been going to Shimla in December. It's like for 10 days camp. And that's when we do. It's not a good ice regulating rink, it's just a natural one, very small. But still we just manage with that because we don't have anything else. And roller skating here, it's a little difficult. So if I get some holidays and all, I'll go to Mysore. There's a good place over there. So over there, practice is nice. So based on that.
This is Yogesh, another medalist.
First of all, my sister was a skater. So I saw her and even I want to skating. She was like my inspiration, what you say. So even I started developing my interest and I wanted to gain more and more. I have a dream of becoming a world champion. So until I reach that goal, I'm not going to stop, whatever it is. That's what I want to do.
And Ashwin De Silva says this.
I started skating in 2008. I was a complete spoil sport. I had no interest in any of the sports, but then my dad, he inspired me, and I kept going, he kept encouraging me, now I'm here. Last 2 months back, I won a medal in Nationals. The credit goes to my dad, no one else, just my dad and my mom. So I just want to thank him.
Mr. Muhammad, one of the parents, expressed their plight like this.
ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಈ ಕೆಲಸ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಿಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮಕ್ಕಳ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ಗೋಸ್ಕರ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಧದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೂಡ ಸಹಕಾರ ಕೊಟ್ಟು ಅವರನ್ನು ಮೇಲೆ ತಂದಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ನಮಗೆ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಈ ರಿಂಕಿಂದಾಗಿ ನಮಗೆ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಮೆಡಲ್ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಸರ್. ನಾವು ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರು, ಮೈಸೂರು ಮತ್ತು ಶಿಮ್ಲಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಟ್ರೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕಳು ಇಷ್ಟ ತನಕ ಮೇಲೆ ಬರಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾರಣ ಆಯಿತು.
ಅಲ್ಲ, ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟೆಲ್ಲ ಖರ್ಚು ಉಂಟು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ರಿಂಕೆಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ನೀವೇ ಒಟ್ಟು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ?
ಹೌದು, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಟ್ಟು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಇದನ್ನು ಬಿಲ್ಡಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೆ. ಮತ್ತು ನಮಗೆ ಮೆಸ್ಕಾಮ್ ಮತ್ತು ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಕೂಡ ತುಂಬ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ ಇದು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ. ನಾವು ಮುಂದೆ ಇದನ್ನು ಇನ್ನೂ 200 meter ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಟಿಂಗ್ ರಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡುವ ಆಲೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಇವಾಗ. ಈಗ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸು ಎಲ್ಲ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಾವೊಂದು ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಕೂಡ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ, ಮಾಡಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಇಷ್ಟು ಡೆವಲಪ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಇದನ್ನು 200 meter ರಿಂಕ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ರಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡುವ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ.
ನೀವು ಒಟ್ಟುಗೂಡಿ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹಣ ನೀವು ಹಾಕ್ತೀರಿ, ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನಾದ್ರು ನಿಮಗೆ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಹೇಗಿಂದ ಬರ್ತದೆ?
ನಮಗೆ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ನಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಹಾಕಿ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ನಮಗೆ ಸೋರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಬೇಡ, ನಾವು ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಂದ ಬರೀ ನಾಮಿನಲ್ ಫೀಸ್ ತಗೊಳ್ತೇವೆ. ನಾವು ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ, ಹೈ ಫ್ಲೈಯರ್ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಕಾಡೆಮಿ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ಕ್ಲಬ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಅದು ರಿಜಿಸ್ಟರ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. 200 meter ರಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ, ಇಂಟರ್ನ್ಯಾಷನಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ರಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೂ ಮೆಡಲ್ ತೆಗೆಯುವಾಗ ಒಂದು ಪ್ರಯತ್ನ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ ನಾವು.
ಇದು ಜಾಗ ನೀವು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ತೆಗೆದದ್ದು ಹೇಗೆ ಬಂದದ್ದು? ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸಬ್ಸಿಡಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರ, ಹೇಗೆ ಬಂದದ್ದು?
ಅಲ್ಲ, ಇದು ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಇಂದ ಬಂತು ನಮಗೆ. ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಟೆಂಡರ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಮಗೆ ಈಗ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ ನಾವು ಮೊದಲು. ನಮಗೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಈಗ ರೆಂಟಲ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಇವಾಗ ನಾವು ಅಗ್ರಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಮುಂದೆ ಅದು 200 meter ರಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಅವ್ರ ಹತ್ರ ಪರ್ಮಿಷನ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ.
ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಸಂಸ್ಥೆ ಇಲ್ಲದ್ರೆ ಯೂತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಇದು ವೆಲ್ಫೇರ್ ಯಾರೋ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಸಬ್ಸಿಡಿ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೀರಾ?
ಇಲ್ಲ, ಇಷ್ಟವರೆಗೆ ಯಾರು ಕೊಡಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಒಂದು 12 lakh ಮತ್ತೆ ಮೆಸ್ಕಾಮ್ 12.5 lakh ಮತ್ತೆ ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಒಂದು 2.5 lakh ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರು. ಎಲ್ಲ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಒಟ್ಟಾಗಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಈಗ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಸಹೋದರ ಭಾವತೆಯಿಂದ ಇದನ್ನು ಮುಂದುವರಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗಿ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ ಆಗಿ 200 meter ರಿಂಕ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಆಲೋಚನೆ ಇದೆ.
ಈಗ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ನಮ್ಮವರು ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅಭಯ್ ಚಂದ್ರ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವರಿಗೆ ಮೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀರಾ? ಅವರು ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವರು
Few of the mothers of the children also express their feelings.
It will cost approximately if you high grade this ring.
It will
more than 60 lakhs.
More than 60 lakhs, because we know our weather in Mangalore. Around 4 to 5 months we can't do outside skating, so we have to have a covering for this permanent, so that it is can be used both ways. And also we want a road facility for road practice, where we have two types of competition. One is a road track is their event, and on the rink event. So we want somewhere a road also to be built around the ring, so that we don't have to go outside in search of roads for road practice. So this is what is our appeal.
At the moment you're practicing on that
Tannir Bhavi road.
Okay, and then you have said that horticulture has given you, is given you the lease, or you're paying some rent or something like that?
Lease facility is going on now. At present we are on the rent. 5,500 rupees per month we are paying rent towards to the horticulture garden.
See, previously the coaching was not up to the mark. Actually it was all parents' efforts. We used to take them to the road, you know, we used to take extra efforts, you know, stay late and get it done for me. First of all, resource is not there. This is the smallest rink, and we have been skating from 5 to 8. We don't have toilet facilities also. In spite of that, you know, my daughter has won a national gold. So if we would have had a good resource, you know, we would have done wonders. Many more kids would have gone for nationals. But I hope some better future.
Infrastructure is coming in. I think you're upgrading it to that international level.
And we would request everybody to, you know, help us with this. You know, anybody would like to sponsor or something.
It's really nice to have children do their best in sports, because that is one of the essential part of growing, along with the education. So since skating is something which is not very popular, but getting popular now, I'm really excited about my children getting into this sport and developing more.
You got any message as a mother?
As a mother, it's very difficult to balance house as well as coming out and getting your children to practice, and as well looking after their education, teaching them, as well as getting them from home to school, to the rink, practice. It's a tough job, but do not give up. Do not give up, because there is everything has to have its place, and everything is important. So it's an overall development of the child, which we have to encourage.
Coach Mr. Raju too spoke to Coastal Times.
This Mangalore children have a lot of potential, actually. The only thing is this infrastructure and the previous coaching techniques, they were like outdated. So we are trying to fill that gap. We are trying to get a international coach, new coach, and around starting from April, May, we will do that.
How many children are under you?
Currently around 40-45 children are there.
At least 40 will represent India? Under you?
Yeah, I mean, we hope so. But yeah, surely around 2025, sure, like starting immediately. But our aim is, you know, all the students, we want to take it to the national level at least. So that is our aim.
How are the parents' cooperation with you?
Great, actually. Because, see, they have taken a lot of risk. If you see, they have put their children's interest backwards for the entire public.
Investors.
So, yeah. So it's kind of become their life. We are only thinking and eating, drinking, only skating nowadays.
And youngest student, what have got here?
I think we have around 4 to 5 years, I think.
It is high time for our government to take interest in this sport, where the children have bagged laurels at the international level without any infrastructure. What if they achieve after a very nice skating rink is provided with all latest facilities is beyond imagination.